Hi students, now the next topic is the pumping lemma for context-free language. You already seen the pumping lemma concept for the regular grammar, okay, regular languages. So in the previous video I explained what is the pumping lemma in the case of regular language. So while they are given the question, you have to clearly read the question. Whenever you are seeing the pumping lemma, don't write about that. First, you need to check whether it is a regular grammar or regular language they are asking, or on the context-free language. Okay, it's a regular language or the context-free language, that you need to be checked. Okay, so in the previous video, I explained, means in the previous videos, the starting of this the subject, I explained about the pumping lemma for the context, not for the regular languages, regular grammar. Now, in this video, I won't explain you about the pumping lemma for context-free language. So before going to know about the pumping lemma for the context-free languages, just recall what is a context-free language. Okay, a context-free language is a language which is generated the context-free grammar. So this context-free language is generating context-free grammar. You already know that the context-free grammar consisting of four tuples. Okay, it's consisting of four tuples. The four tuples are nothing but V, sigma, S, P. These are the four tuples which is the context-free grammar consisting of. V is nothing but the non-terminal, set of non-terminal. Sigma is the input symbols and S is the start symbol and P is the production rules. That is the definition of the context-free grammar. Okay, a context-free language is a language which is generated some of the context-free grammars. The context-free grammars is defined as a four tuples, V, sigma, S, P. V is a set of non-terminals, sigma is the input symbols, S is a start symbol and P is the production rules. Now coming to this pumping lemma for context-free language. A pumping lemma for context-free language is used to prove that a language is not a context-free. So the thing here is, a pumping lemma, what is the use of the pumping lemma? The pumping lemma is used to prove that the language is not a context-free. It is not a context-free. Whatever the language that they are given, we have to prove that it is not a context-free. So for this, we have to take a contradiction we have to take. Means we have to assume, let us the given grammar, given language is a context-free language and try to prove it is not a context-free. So if it is not a context-free, means it is a pumping lemma. Okay, so that is the way you have to solve. First, you need to take the contradiction. We have to assume that the given language is a context-free language and try to solve that it is not a context-free language. If it is not a context-free, then it is pumping lemma, because the pumping lemma is used to prove that the language is not a context-free. Let's see the theorem. What is the conditions of this pumping lemma? We're showing that it is not a context-free. Assume L. L is a context-free language. Okay, let us take a language L, which is a context-free language. There is a pumping length. Some length should be there. By entering the pumping length, we can identify whether the language is context-free or not. Okay, so first assume L is a context-free language. There is a pumping length N such that any string, whatever the string that you are taken, okay, that any string in the that string should belongs to the language, okay, that any string that belongs to the language of length greater than or equal to 1, the length of that pumping lemma should be greater than or equal to 1, n, and can be written as this, mod w is greater than or equal to n. This is the first condition. And we can break W into 5 strings. Actually, this is a condition for that the mod W, that is the length of this string, is greater than or equal to the given pumping length N. We can break W into 5 strings. W is equal to U, V, X, Y, Z. U, V, X, Y, Z. Such that mod V, X, Y means this. The mod V, X, Y is less than or equal to N. And mod vy, this mod vy does not belongs to the epsilon symbol. It does not be empty. It does not be zero, because it has a power. Based on that vy only, we are going to decide whether the given context-free language is a context-free language or not. we have to decide. Okay, so we break the this string into 5 strings u, v, x, y, z, where v, x, y is less than or equal to n. So these 3 should be less than or equal to the given string length, and mod v, y, this v and y does not belongs to the empty string. And for all k greater than or equal to 0, we have to take a power that should be greater than or equal to 0. The string u, v power k, x, y power k, z belongs to language. Okay? If it belongs to the language. So, this is a contradiction we are taking. Okay? Select k. We have to select the k in a way that in the result, the string is not in language. Actually, this is a condition. V power k, x, y power k, z belongs to L. Whatever the k value that you are taking, that is from greater than or equal to 0. If that k value you have to take in a manner such that the resulting string is does not belongs to language. In that way, you need to be taking. Then we can say that the pumping lemma is proved that the given language is not a context-free language. Now let's see what are the steps that we have to take. So if you understand the steps, in the next video I'll take an example to prove that the pumping lemma is not a it's not a context free language. Whatever the language that is given, that it is not a context free language. Now let's see, to prove that a language is not a context free using a pumping lemma context free language, we have to follow these steps. So what I said, just take a contradiction method, means let us assume that language whatever we are taking is a context free language, and we have to prove that that language does not belongs to the context free language. So first assume that it belongs to, assume that L is a context free. So starts with the contradiction, and we have to prove using contradiction method. So I have started with the contradiction. I am assuming that the given language is a context free, and I have to prove that it is not a context free. There is a problem. Solution. So the pumping length, say n, let me take some pumping length is n, and all strings longer than n can be pumped into mod w is greater than or equal to n according to our condition. Now find a string w in L such that w is greater than or equal to n. So whatever the string that I found in language, that is divided into 5 strings u, v, x, y, z, and we have to show that u into v power k, x, y power k, z. Only v and y has the powers. U, v power k, x, y power k, z does not belongs to L for some k. Whatever k you are taking, that we have to show that it does not belongs to the language. Then consider the ways that w can be divided into u, v, x, y, z, and show that none of these can satisfy all the 3 pumping conditions. So we have to show that it's not satisfying all the 3 pumping conditions. So what are the 3 pumping conditions? So these are the 3 pumping conditions. These are the 3 cases. Mod v, x, y is less than or equal to n, mod v, y does not belongs to the epsilon, and u, v power k, x, y power k, z belongs to L. In this, any one of the condition has to be failed. Means none of the condition, not any one. All the condition. If one is failed, automatically the remaining is also being failed. Okay, you no need to check that. So one case is enough to check whether the language is context free or not. So show that none of these can satisfy all the 3 pumping conditions at the same time. So then we can, W cannot be pumped, which is a contradiction. So in the next video, I will take an example to prove that the pumping lemma for context-free language is, I mean, whatever the language they are given for the context-free language is not a context-free. Thank you.